This is the new Canon G7X Mark III, and it actually has a microphone input. So that's great news, but there's no way to actually attach an external microphone to the camera. So in this video, I will explore pretty much every available option to make use of this new microphone input on the G7X Mark III. My name is Bram de Wijs, and if you are a regular viewer of the videos on my channel, you must be surprised because this is my first video in English and I'm not really a tech reviewer. So to them, I will just say one thing in Dutch. Als je hier bent voor de normale video's en je bent niet geïnteresseerd in technische dingen met camera's en microfoons, kun je deze video overslaan. This here is my old G7X Mark II. As you see, the screen is pretty much falling off. The rubber grip is kind of peeling off slowly. I think it's almost 3 years old and I can say this camera has seen the entire world, pretty much. And I think I filmed over 1,000 hours of footage with this one. So, you know, I love this camera. I'm really happy with it. The one thing I love most about it, except for the image quality, is that it fits right in my pocket. So I can take it with me all the time, anywhere. Even on days when I'm not even sure I want to make a vlog, I want to film stuff, I'll just take it with me just in case something interesting happens. Love it. There's just one thing I really hate about the G7X Mark II, and that's the audio quality. Last weekend I went to the Amsterdam Pride and I made a vlog about it with my G7X. And you know, I've kind of found a way to talk to this camera when there's a lot of music in the background and still make myself understandable.
We gaan beginnen, de eerste boot komt eraan, denk ik.
And it's actually quite simple. As long as you're speaking very loudly into the camera, you will be able to hear yourself. But I also decided to interview some friends about why they think Pride is important. And most of the interviews sounded like this.
Dat de alledaags allemaal voor wie...
That sucks, you can barely hear their voices. I had to write subtitles for almost the entire vlog and I hate making subtitles. So sometimes when I go to a place where there's a lot of background music or background noise or a lot of people talking, I bring my Canon 80D. I'm filming with this one right now. Well, not this one, of course, but... And this Rode shotgun mic, it's the Video Mic Pro, I think. Is really, really good. Even if you're in a room filled with kids screaming, as long as you point your camera and your microphone to the person you're interviewing, you will only hear them. So I really love this setup as well, but if you're going to a party or traveling, or if you're on the Amsterdam Pride walking around all day, it's just not an option because it doesn't fit in your pocket. So I was very happy and pretty surprised actually that the new Canon G7X Mark III has a microphone input. It's a 3.5 mini jack input like on the Canon 80D. So you could actually, theoretically, use this amazing microphone on this amazing small camera. Except there's not actually a way to attach an external microphone to the Canon G7X Mark III. And also if you would use a microphone this big on the camera this small, that makes no sense. What you could do is use a lav mic like this one. You could plug it in directly into the camera like I'm doing right now. Or you could even buy the Rode Wireless Go to make a microphone like this wireless. I think that's pretty cool if you're making a video like this. But if you're just making a regular vlog about your day, talking to other people, this is not gonna work. And also, I think you'd look pretty silly wearing a microphone like this to a restaurant or to a party or a festival. It's almost as if you're the local news reporter, and I don't think that's gonna work for me. So I figured the perfect microphone for the G7X Mark III would be one of those very small microphones they make for smartphones. So the first one I tried is the Rode VideoMic Me. It's very small, it's about 60 euros. Sound quality should be great because it's Rode, and it sounded like this. It doesn't work at all, there's no audio recorded because the plug is actually made for smartphones. So it doesn't work on the stereo mini jack in on the G7X. So I tried another one that's even smaller. It's the Ceremonic SmartMic Mobile. It's about 30 euros and you can actually bend it in any direction. So if you're vlogging like this, you can put it like that. If you're vlogging like this, you can bend it like that. Pretty much perfect, except it sounded like this. No sound, it's the same problem. It's a smartphone plug, it doesn't work on G7X. So good to know. Then there's this very small boy. It's actually the DJI FlexiMic. It's meant for use with the DJI Stabilizer because the internal audio of the Osmo Stabilizer is actually pretty crappy. And if you use this microphone on your stabilizer, you would get rid of all the stabilizing sounds. So it's DJI, it's only 6 euros, so I thought, let's give it a try.
Dit is een test met het microfoontje van Osmo, terwijl ik hem een beetje opzij buig, wat niet ideaal is. Maar het zou kunnen.
Zonder microfoon, zonder externe microfoon, dus dit is gewoon de microfoon van de G7X.
Zo is het als hij naar de zijkant zit.
It actually doesn't sound bad. You would have to hold your camera and bend it at the same time. Or if you're interviewing someone, you have to bend it like this. Or so I thought, because I discovered it doesn't even matter in which way you bend it. Because it's an omnidirectional microphone. So that means it picks up sound from the front, from the back, from all the sides, from anywhere. And that's actually a big disadvantage because the built-in microphone, the internal microphone of the G7 X, is also an omnidirectional microphone. And we want a unidirectional microphone to get rid of all the background noise. So this one, it's cheap, but not so good. So then I found this one, the Olympus ME 25W. It's very small. It actually looks kind of cool. This is the microphone. You can bend it like this, put it in like that. It's only 22 euros. It's from Olympus, which is a pretty good brand, I think. It also comes with a clip like this one and some extra cable. And it's actually a noise cancelling microphone. And I think its intended use is to plug into your recorder or if you're a teacher, you want to record your presentation. I think that's what it's made for, but it fits very nicely. The bending is pretty ideal, I think. You can put it in your pocket or even leave it in because it's very small. And this is what it sounds like.
Dit is een test met de noise cancelling microfoon van Olympus, ME52W. En het nadeel van deze microfoon is dat je vaak heel veel omgevingsgeluid hoort.
Zo klinkt hij als je hem wat verder weg houdt. Zo klinkt hij als je hem dichtbij houdt. First of all, it's a mono microphone, which is good. That's what we want. We want it to be as focused in one direction as possible, so you only need one channel. But maybe you could hear it if you're listening with headphones. Pretty much all the audio is on the left side, and there is some low frequency rumble on the right side. So it's actually stereo somehow. So I think what might be happening is the noise cancelling just takes off some low frequencies and puts it on the right side to get rid of it. And on the left side, it actually boosts the high frequencies and mid frequencies. So my S's sound very sharp. I don't really like it.
En zo klinkt die als je wat harder praat.
And of course, you could fix all that in your editing software. You could combine the two channels and put them in the middle again. So you have like a neutral sounding channel. And you could cut off some of the very high frequencies to make it sound a little better. But I would very much prefer a microphone that already sounds great without any added software processing. So this one, it's an option, but it's not perfect. There are more microphones like this, like very small and bendable, mostly intended for use in a laptop. But most of those microphones are very cheap, like 5 euros or less. There's no brand name on them. And they're omnidirectional, so that's not what we're looking for. So I didn't even bother to order them and try them out. But if you are having great results with a microphone like this on the G7X, please let me know in the comments because I would love to know. Next up is the Rode Video Micro. It's also 60 euros, just like the Video Mic Me. I think it's actually pretty much the same microphone, except this one has a cable and this suspension unit to attach it to a hot shoe or cold shoe, which I think makes it a little chunky to use on your G7X, which doesn't have a cold shoe or hot shoe. So I figured out some creative ways to attach it. I put some Velcro on the camera and some Velcro on the microphone. And actually it's quite a nice compact setup. It's holding okay, I guess. Maybe you could add some tape or I tried it with a rubber band and then it sounded like this.
En dit is een test met de Rode Video Micro. En hij zit met klittenband aan de camera vast. Met een elastiekje eromheen. Dit is de audio zonder microfoon, dus gewoon de audio van de camera zelf. Dit is de audio met de Rode Video Micro.
I just don't feel this is the perfect sustainable solution. I would be afraid to lose my microphone all the time. And with a rubber band, I don't know, in Dutch we would call it houtje touwtje. So I figured out a way to actually attach a cold shoe to the G7X. This is the cold shoe from Small Rig. I think it's 10 euros, quite expensive for a small piece of metal like this. And you could screw the Small Rig onto the bottom of your G7X and then sort of hang the microphone underneath it, which makes it sound like this.
Dit is een test met de rode video micro. Maar dan onder de camera, zonder microfoon, zonder externe microfoon. Dus dit is gewoon de microfoon van de G7X. Het jammer is dat hij een beetje gaat hangen, omdat hij een beetje zwaar is geworden van de windfilter.
And even though the microphone is pointing somewhat below the sound you're trying to record, it actually sounds pretty good. But I still don't think this is the perfect setup, because you can't even put your camera down anymore. And it looks kind of weird. So then I was about to give up. Maybe I should just consider buying the Canon M50 instead of the G7X, which is a little bigger, but it actually has a way to attach a microphone to it. Maybe I should just accept the crappy quality of the audio on the G7X. But there was one thing left I had to try out. This piece of plastic is called a flash bracket, or in Dutch we say flitsbeugel. This one is from Hama. It was 10 euros, but I think you can even get it cheaper. It's meant to put underneath your camera so you can add an external flash, but you can also use it to screw it on your G7X and add a cold shoe. So you put your Rode Video Micro on there, plug it in to the G7X. It doesn't look bad. It's chunky, but it actually makes the camera a little steadier to hold on to. The mic is pointing slightly in the wrong direction because it's next to the camera, but it sounds like this.
En dit is een test met de Hama flitsbeugel en erop de Rode Video Micro.
But if you're filming like this and you are talking to the camera, it will sound like this.
Dit is een test met de Rode Video Micro als je erachter staat met de Hama setup erop.
This setup doesn't fit in my pocket. So maybe if you attach the shoulder strap to it, you can just carry it around like this. If you're going outside, you would have to put on the windshield, which makes it a little bit, as we would say in Dutch, lomp. But if we consider all the other options, I think this setup is still the best way to make a kind of portable, great sounding setup for your G7X Mark III. And of course, I hope Rode or even Canon itself will be making a microphone especially for the G7X. That would be great. If you have another solution or tips or advice or questions, please let me know in the comments. And if you're curious about my vlogs, I actually have some videos with English subtitles. I'll put a link to the playlist in the corner. And thanks for watching, or as we say in Dutch, bedankt voor het kijken. Bye!
Nou, lekker scherp, vriend.